fuck. She got me. She got me high as fuck. She got me. High as fuck.
High as fuck by the Time Seekers. They're some of the Pigs Radio's friends. Remember when we had that one thing called the Pigs Radio Pig Dazzery that happened back in March at the fucking Mal's? Remember when you did all that fucking cocaine and you did fucking crazy things and got your balls licked and shit?
There wasn't that much.
Did you get your balls licked?
You got your balls licked, right? No?
Or get licked, actually.
Wait, what?
What do you mean no comment?
Actually? Yeah, actually, what happened?
It was good times.
We need to know.
It was a pig dastrophe, so there were some good times.
Some asshole licking and shit? Yours in particular or not?
Nah, just tickling. Just the rim. Just the rim.
Grab the balls, let the pig.
Oh, dude, you got a rim job?
Nah.
No? Yes? No. Aw.
A gentleman never tells.
There wasn't enough cocaine.
This is the underdog. This ain't no gentleman.
Just sell it in. There was not enough cocaine for that.
It was a good time. There was some fucking paddles.
There was paddles.
Ping pong paddles?
By the way, for the guest that we have tonight.
I can barely even hear myself. Is this a...
All right.
Yeah, there you go. There you go.
Good job, Pete. God damn it. Fucking intern.
I'm so proud of you.
You know what, dude? Put your fucking hand out, dude. We're going to do this shit like fucking Catholic school.
Knuckles. Knuckles.
No.
Ooh.
Not at all.
Yes.
Break your shit.
So, yeah. So, for all the guests that we have in today, we have fucking free paddles. I don't know. Give that shit out.
Yay, Santa came early.
Dude, I need a stir stick for my paint.
I can spank myself because I can never.
Actually, that's
kind of
nice, dude. It has like a curvature to it.
Your boyfriend won't spank you?
No, I can't spank him, which is not the fun part.
Oh, all right. Well, we can dive into that stuff. By the way, we also got free condoms, guys. So here, hustler.
What are those?
I got plenty of those.
What are those?
Yeah, I bet.
Who uses that? They say.
That's right. I forget. The underdog really does believe in the Lord's way.
I go to the Lord's
bareback Bronson.
Pull out and pray.
Just in the butthole. Just
pull
in the butthole.
Pull out and pray.
The church looks down upon on condoms.
True. Catholic church does.
Yes,
I'm a very good Catholic. Let's say that.
Jesus, God's will.
So you like little boys then, right?
Oh. Oh.
I don't believe in contraceptives, you know?
What about marriage?
What?
Satan, here I come.
That escalated.
If Jesus didn't marry, why should I? You know what I mean?
That escalated quickly.
Exactly.
Well, of course, always fighting the evil odds. That is the underdog. What's up, underdog?
What's up, you motherfuckers?
All right, so we got really personal with you today.
That's a long introduction.
It really was. We weren't trying to do the whole, you know, that, but.
I felt like I was under investigation, got the spotlight on me.
Yeah, did we even do
cross
the
examine?
We're doing that now, actually. Oh, okay. All right. So, yeah. So, we got way too much information, so we don't want to hear about you anymore.
Yeah, fuck you. Cool.
But, obviously, the person who has the most secrets, because he's just the glamorous of glams, the inside, outside. I can't tell which closet you're part of, but it's a very mystery nigga, and we're still wondering what you are.
The outside.
Do you know what you are right now? Are you an innie or an outie right now?
Pepe Le Pew.
Which would it be?
We at Long Beach Pride or what?
Actually, we're at Pride.
I just happened to go to Long Beach today. I just happened to drive into Long Beach today.
All right, just come on.
It wasn't for that. I was looking for records, you know, at fucking.
Records?
Yeah, vinyl records. Yeah. Like,
just be yourself, bro.
Like a hipster.
And I just happened to stumble across like a bunch of gay dudes and shit that were looking for records too.
Did you have cut off shorts?
And they wanted to trade records in the bathroom. 50. So I'm like, all right, let's go trade some records.
Yeah, cut off shorts.
Yeah, yep. I'll totally do that. Fucking shorts. For sure. Fucking lumberjack boots. Yeah.
I like how we can always go to you and find out what all the gays are talking about and raving. So
it's all a rave, allegedly. Now. It's all a rave.
But we do have our retard intern. We love him. We hate him. But we only ask you back because your girlfriend's really hot and we ask her to come back. Let's give it up for Cuban Pete. What's up, Cuban Pete?
Not much, man. Not much.
Not much.
And that's Cuban Pete. Thank you.
Good job, Pete.
Thank you.
Pete. All right, you're going to have a new chat.
I almost died. Almost died the weekend, so you probably would have.
Okay, what? Okay, you know when they say, like, on the tags, don't rip off the tags and put in your mouth and shit? Why'd you do that? Is that what you did?
You're not supposed to eat that little packet that says do not eat.
Exactly.
Wait, did you say pocket? Because this guy has pockets in his stomach. It's really weird. Yeah, it's we talk about weird. That shit all the time. He has mystery pockets.
No, nothing.
Like
completely.
A cow. He hides like food
in that realm.
Oh, cows have.
So how'd you die? Or how'd you almost die? So
I partied in TJ, man. And
what's a bachelor?
A bachelor's party in TJ.
Uh-oh.
Yeah. Now.
You still have your livers?
Were you okay with it, Mrs. P? I don't know. What are we? Okay. I don't know.
Yeah,
Mrs.
it was
P.
my brother's.
Oh, so you're okay with him going to a bachelor party in Tijuana?
Yeah, but I didn't think it was going to be that crazy.
It's Tijuana.
He called me and was like,
and a bachelor party.
I don't know where I'm at. Give me somebody. You need to figure out where I'm at. And I was like, okay.
I mean, well, did you go also?
No.
Okay, so you do know that like the party section in TJ, right next to it is like notorious for all the hookers and all that stuff. What? Right under.
Tell your story, please.
Oh, dang.
Let's jump
wait,
into the story.
Wait, can we pitch this? Hold on.
Are we going?
Hold on. Hold on.
With the introduction
wait
before we jump into.
Wait. I'm just gonna say is that you let him go to TJ to go party.
That's
no,
exactly what
you
we're
have
talking.
A fucking secret like GPS like implanted in your asshole. Just to
look,
let you know,
when
she was fisting you with her fucking finger
called,
that one day,
it's called the phone, and she can track me.
No, he needs to be chipped.
Yeah, no, dude, you're straight up chipped.
She
you
does
don't even
work
know.
At a roamer, huh? Exactly.
She works at a veterinary office, so that's easily
I probably
chipped
him, huh? Yeah.
Oh, no, honey. I just bit you. It's fine. It'll heal in any day now.
You guys are giving away her secrets, though.
it's no secret. Definitely no secret.
I've already been neutered, so
I don't
I'm good.
Honestly.
There we go.
Aw.
All right, so what happened? You went to TJ and...
it was... I'm going to just speed over to where I almost died. I was called into a room, and I was told, give me your money. And I told him, well...
Bye.
Well,
where were you at? What room? You have to give some by her brother?
That's not some good storytelling, dude. You're kind of leaving like a mass, like a couple of...
So the bachelor party started in San Diego. We went brewery hopping. Right. Went to Latitude 33.
Stone.
We didn't hit Stone.
Ah, you guys
we
fucking
hit
Belching
Beaver.
Idiots.
Belching Beaver, which was like the favorite.
Right.
We ended up going to... I can't think right now.
Not Stone.
That's not true. That's
we didn't go Stone.
Yeah, okay. So
we had Ballast Point, and then we also had... I can't get it. Ballast Point, Latitude 33.
He drank that much, guys.
Yeah, it was
how about you tip the mic a little bit closer so we can hear
I'm
you better?
I'm telling you, dude. Something's wrong with the mic.
Yeah, you're not talking into it.
Yeah, you're talking into it.
Dumbass.
That's what's wrong with the
talk
mic.
Talk into it like there. A big dick.
All right.
Yeah.
See?
So much better.
Oh, my God. It's shutting in my mouth.
It's fucking...
it feels dirty.
Gay pride all over again.
Now we know what happened in TJ.
Yeah.
Oh, well, whatever.
Tim brings back memories.
Iron Fist. There you go. Finally. Iron Fist was the last one.
So you went drinking. So you guys went drinking.
Fuck, we were lit.
Bachelor party.
We went fucking for four breweries. We sampled a lot.
He said lit.
That means drugs, right?
You learned that over there.
That means your butt still hurts?
I was fucking drunk. You've
been hanging out with the kids.
Your butt hurt.
I was butt fucking drunk. We go. I remember eating a burger at In-N-Out. And we started.
They have those in TJ?
No, we ended up going after that. We went to TJ. So once we get to TJ, we go to some shitty ass bar, man.
Called Adelitas,
like,
right?
Was it a plan to go to TJ?
The plan.
Okay,
that was
so
the plan.
Just
so
started it up in San Diego, and then moved over.
So we're like, so we just did craft. So let's get a craft beer.
You guys did
crack? Worse.
No,
I heard crack.
No, TJ, it's crap, not craft.
Just do the cocaine.
It was the worst fucking beer I've ever had. Like even the other guy was telling me, like, dude, I don't even know how you were able to fucking drink it.
It's bum piss.
I like a trooper, I fucking took it down. We went to.
Ooh, yeah.
We go to.
Did we have the same dad? He taught me that too.
We go across the street to some club, man, and I gotta say I had like the blaster. It was.
Titties.
It was the shit. It was packed with people, well lit. Like you can actually.
Well
lit.
A lit.
Yeah. I wasn't gonna say.
No, it was lit. It was lit. This is where you ship from.
That was literal. I think he meant like the lighting.
Oh, there was lighting.
Okay.
There was actual lighting.
I'm
helping him, guys.
No. So you could
see. The idea, but.
You could see people, and it wasn't like the clubs out here where it's dark as fuck, and you have to like, wait, is she hot? No, these girls, you could tell these people.
You saw the beard.
Like it's like.
No, you saw the stubble, the 5 o'clock shadow.
No, I don't like walking out and be like,
right.
I want to know what I'm looking at. Right. So
yeah, I asked him. I'm like, so how was it over there? You know, were they kind of hot? Were they hot? And he's like, do you want to know the truth? And I'm expecting.
Truth or the lies?
First of all, why would you even say that?
I want to know if there's like
no
two
him.
Strippers out there.
Hey,
he's like, do you want to know the truth? And I'm like, yeah. Like compared to Sam.
Oh
like,
no. Haven't even got there yet.
Oh okay.
Oh sorry.
So the club we didn't even spend there long. We took off.
Still the intro. Right?
We ended up going to another fucking shitty bar.
Where were you guys? What part?
No, never mind. Never mind.
It's Zapata, all shitty. Stop Plaza saying that. They're all
there,
shitty.
There are some good clubs in TJ. Like, I don't know where the fuck he was at, but yeah.
It was like Plaza de Zapatos or some shit like that.
Zapata?
Zapata, maybe.
Indoor wow. Shit, dude.
If any of you crazy fucks listening right now have been a TJ and just whatever, can you help him out? Call in at 909-475-7449. Pete, you're a fucking retard. Hurry the fuck up.
We go to
it gets good.
Like I said, you
won. It gets good. All right, go.
So we go to Ananitas.
Oh, and shit. Okay.
Adelitas, right.
Alan, and it was fucking whack.
Yeah, you go to Alanets.
It was fucking whack. It was whack.
It was whack?
It was whack as fuck. It was dead as fuck.
This was on a Saturday night, right?
We go, and then, yeah, it was Saturday night.
Yeah, all the good hoes were probably taken early. All right,
so we go to Hong Kong. And, man.
You went to Hong Kong?
Hong Kong, man. From that TJ? Fucking. You open the fucking door. It was like walking into fucking heaven. It was. The shit. It was like a fucking club, and all the girls were fucking naked, dude. It was like 60, 70 girls that were there. It was.
And this was jam-packed. Like by there.
Yeah, by it was like. Litas. I want to say it was. I don't remember. Right. And before you know it.
I don't know. This is going to be a really good story.
Before you know it, I remember going towards the back to the room. And I remember
he said, I got lured in a room. I'm like, this ain't no Pokemon game, babe. Like, what you lured
in a room? How do you get lured? And she goes, oh.
Retarded chew. I choose you.
So I fucking got called in. And
serving the retard.
As soon as I walk in, some guy pushes me down and tells me to sit down. He tells me, give me the money.
Did he say it like this? Siéntate, cabrón.
It wasn't too aggressive. It was
he was like, sir, can you please have a seat, sir?
it was somewhere in the world, like, sit down kind of deal.
Take a seat.
He was telling me, give me your money. And I told him, I don't got any. He's like, what do you mean you don't have any? I gave it away. Where the fuck am I? I told him, so I got nothing. And I tried to show him, try to get up to prove to him I ain't got no money. I literally came with a certain amount, and that money's gone.
And you blew it where? At the
horse?
Bar?
I'm going to strip it up.
A naked horse.
You're going to test him, right?
How is he still alive?
I should.
STD test him?
Yeah, you should.
And it you can see him bickering. It was the girl and the guy, and I'm over here thinking, like, I should get the fuck out of here.
Well, she
right
took
now.
You back there because he that was the pimp, dude. Mm-hmm. He was trying to get the money for the hoe.
Well,
were you trying to buy her?
You're the John.
All right, so I fucking. All right, so I get out through the back door. Before you know it, I black. I'm like, I'm telling you, I wake up in a cab, and the guy's telling me, give me money. And I'm over here telling him, get me to a fucking bank and I'll get you your fucking money,
right.
Which we are. So I pull out my phone, and as soon as I pull it out, he fucking snatches it from me. And I'm over here thinking, like, hey, dude, like, what the fuck? He goes, give me the money and I'll fucking give you
the phone back.
Yeah, phone back and I get you to the fucking border.
Right.
And I was like, all right, cool. I step out like a fucking, you know, to get the money. He drives off, dude.
Well, you know, that brand new iPhone fucking 28 or whatever the fuck this fool's rocking.
And I can see it. I can see it like that Dumb and Dumber where that old lady got robbed by an old lady. You know, he walks into that room. I felt that way. I felt like dropping down on my knees and being like, what the fuck just happened?
You're and
I don't know how long I was walking for. I'm at the border.
Oh, no.
I go.
Let me in, please.
I go. I give him my passport. And I can tell, like, by the guy's face,
his reaction?
Whatever, his reaction to what I'm telling him. He's like,
this is about to cry, man.
He's like, yeah, this guy's
you're not
still,
from here. No, you're not from Mexico.
You told him what happened?
I could tell him. He's like, oh, what were you doing in TJ? And I can tell that I was making no
sense. I wasn't buying horse, sir.
I was, you know, I can tell that he was not understanding what I was telling him because I was still pretty drunk. And he just kind of gave me a passport and told me to walk on. So I remember going to the crossing the border, and I see a payphone. So I go to a place, get money out.
What's a payphone?
They did, right? Right at the end of the fucking block, dude. And I thank God that there was a fucking payphone. I walk up to it, I throw some quarters in, and I fucking tell her. I tell her, hey, baby, don't get mad.
This is like 6 in the morning.
Don't get mad. I lost my phone. But I need you to call your brother to let him know where I'm at.
And did he come rescue you?
He did.
Wow.
He was apparently looking for me for about an hour or 2 hours, he said. And then I seen him crossing the border. He tells me what happened. I tell him the story. And I go, although this all happened, I had a fucking blast, man. It was fucking epic.
So really, he was off boning some hoe for a couple hours. Then he finally walked out. He's like, oh, what happened to fucking Pete? All right.
So for the most part, I'm fucking glad.
That's what my brother thought. Because when I called him to tell him where he was at, he's like, I didn't want to answer your call because I didn't want to tell you that. I didn't know where Ruben was. I was like,
and
found him.
And that was my biggest fear because I wander when we go to Vegas and the exact same thing happened. So
Vegas, you're all right. You're like in.
I'm in LA. Hold on. This has happened twice to you already?
No, that's happened.
Yeah, he's definitely like a live version of the Hangover, you know?
Yeah, I at Vegas, every time I go, I black out and I wander.
Have you not killed him yet?
No, we weren't together.
I'm planning it.
You're planning? Okay, that makes sense.
She doesn't have enough money for the insurance yet.
Technically, he should have been the guy that wakes up in the bathtub with the ice on top of him with a liver.
And that's exactly what I said. So. My biggest fear, fuck it. You know what? Lost my phone. At least it's not a kidney. Fuck it.
My brother was like, I thought he was going to be like in an alley in a tub of ice or something.
Hopefully
he doesn't have any nudes of you, you know what I mean? Because if not, that should be on the net in no time.
He does.
Ah, fuck.
Of course he does.
A lot of them.
Ooh.
And how many people are on that phone that he has now?
Oh no, his new one.
I'm sorry.
The one that the guy stole.
Where were you?
Oh, pictures. I'm sure there's pictures of me. A lot of pictures of me.
Yeah, but
is your phone at least locked?
Yeah, it is.
Oh, okay, there you go.
Y'all think it matters?
Yeah.
Yeah, because you can actually remote fucking delete all that shit right now.
Yeah, I could. Yeah. Yeah.
I'm sure
even then.
Too late now.
Even if you try to reboot it.
Let the world know, babe.
Even if you try to reboot it. The cloud. The cloud doesn't let you fucking unlock the phone anyway. So
yeah, yeah.
They have ways around that. Don't worry.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Dude, you can, off that shit, you can give it a call and fucking they'll delete everything.
Yeah, no, I got it.
All right, one of these days. So anyway, so once you break up with Pete, just so know, you're welcome back anytime. Fuck Pete.
Thank
you. You're more funnier and prettier than him, so we're not. Anything,
at very least, get him tested. Get him tested just in case.
You should put him on a short leash, even shorter now. Don't let him move.
Even shorter?
Yeah. Give him a pincher collar. Pincher collar is the best.
Pincher collar.
Fucking Pete. How do you end up in the room and then almost get fucking killed?
That's what she fucking told me. I was like, trust me.
I got lured
in,
babe.
Even if he was a pimp.
Come here, little boy. I got candy for you.
I had no money. It's not like he was going to be like, okay, it's free on us. Like, no, it's not going to happen. It's on the house.
Yeah. But what if he would have had the money, though?
I wouldn't even know what was happening.
Underdog, what do you think?
That was my thing. What if you would have had the money? Then what would have happened in that room?
So show of hands. A show of hands. Who thinks that?
Pete would have fucked?
Yeah, if you had the money.
I was too drunk to
Damn.
Fuck.
Damn. Even your own chick thinks you would have fucked.
I would have been too drunk to fuck.
She would have spat on his dick.
Oh, then, no, he wouldn't. Please. When he's too drunk, he can't.
Yeah, we already established that. Whiskey dick.
Yes!
But that doesn't mean that there wouldn't have been an attempt.
Exactly.
I don't give a fuck.
After every episode.
It might not have crossed the finish line, but there would have been a goal set.
No, I believe you.
No.
I honestly feel like even worse for them every time.
I know. But you know what, though? But what you have to look at is that, look at the strong love bond.
You feel bad for us?
For you. For you.
We've talked about her raping me when I'm drunk.
Yeah.
Why does she even have to do that?
Because he was drunk.
Tired. He was
because
tired.
He had that nice ass and shit. She just had to get at it.
Wait. You know if Pete has a nice ass, you have a nice ass? Is that the reason why you're still with Pete?
Look at them cheeks.
Because he has a nice ass?
No, I don't think so.
You know, why do you think she's still with you?
Yeah, why do you think I'm still with you?
Yeah, just curious.
Look, it's gay pride. It's gay pride weekend, right? Let's see the ass.
Genuine. I don't lie. I tell the truth. For the most part, I'm fucking who I say I am. That's it.
Okay.
Cuban you're Pete. Not Cuban,
can you agree?
Okay.
Exactly.
Is that you gonna agree to that answer? Is that why? Because he tells you the truth.
I don't say I'm more or less.
He tells me he gets lured in rooms.
A lot, apparently.
It was one room. A teal.
It was just one room.
Oh, wait. How do you remember the color of the fucking room?
It was fucking
Wait, how does he remember all the fucking details and shit?
But he blacked out.
Because he was lured, and he was like, his senses were high.
There was more to the story, but obviously it's not going to come out right now.
Uh-oh. Why?
Oh, a second powder to be continued.
Right now.
You know what? I'm done hearing about the story, because none of that had to do with anything about weed. And that's very epic. Now, today's guest, we're going to learn everything about weed and weed stuff, and hopefully some.
Look at Ronnie. Ronnie's like so excited.
Well, she doesn't like weed because you're a terrorist and no one likes you.
Well, actually, my people.
It's
do
true.
Weed.
Yeah, she's a terrorist. She's fucking.
My people do Afghan.
What?
I thought you guys did opium.
Yeah, there are multiple the strains. Yeah. Afghan.
They do
Afghan strains.
Yeah, they do that. They do opiates. They also have like a lot of weed going around fucking Afghanistan and in Iran.
Heroin and all that shit. Yeah, for sure.
Yeah, heroin and meth are probably bigger. And actual opiate is what they smoke, but they also smoke weed in Iran.
Did you bring some?
No, I don't. I don't like it.
I have a little.
Ooh.
Mm. Of opiates?
No, oh. I wish though. No.
All right, so my dear, give us your name and tell us exactly what you used to do at a shop.
I'm Ashley, and I used to be a a manager at a medical marijuana dispensary.
Ooh, a manager. So this is like a top tier, right? Before you actually own the shit. I don't know how the chain of command goes.
No.
Is it like a gang? You have to get jumped in and sworn in and shit like that? Or?
Oh, to own one? Yeah, it's almost like you have to get jumped in. Managers are 17 steps behind owners. You don't get to know anything except for
the current price of weed.
Exactly.
And retail pricing.
Exactly.
So how long have you worked in the shops for?
I've been in the industry for 3 years.
Now, in weed time, is it like dog's time? But, you know, like...
In weed time, it's like 12 years. Like, damn. I feel like I'm 30.
Okay. That makes a lot of sense. You write that down. That's fucking weed math right there. We're going to learn a lot about weed math today.
We have a lot of times four. It's times four. It's times 420.
So there you go.
Yeah. So give me a fucking point, you dig it.
That's a lot.
All right. So, say, for example, if I smoked weed, quote unquote, and I don't have a card or anything, what's my first step? What do I do to get to the weed shop?
Just show them a 20.
Have friends.
Show them a 20? You have friends.
Have friends.
Yeah? Your friends got friends?
Oh, yeah.
All right, that's what's up. Write that down.
My got hella friends.
All right, we have friends. We have pigs friends, so I don't know what's up.
Talk about friends. Like Benjamin's food.
Like what?
Like Benjamin's.
Sometimes they got
to
be.
He's going to have to hit the sap button for the urban stuff. That's just a little bit. Yeah, sorry.
I got you.
Yeah, okay, cool.
There you go. Thank you.
Now, Rona, you are back to pigs. Thank you for coming back.
You're welcome.
And to get a twist on this, I feel like I'm inside of like a fucking soap opera. She's your daughter.
Dun, dun, dun.
That's my mom. That's my baby.
You should have heard some of the black on black shit that was going on earlier, dude. I was like, damn, she's about to fucking knock her out. But then like they're all cool and laughing and shit. Like,
fart.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, good job on the assist.
Thank you, underdog.
I'm trying.
So, wow. You guys have a weird thing, and I like it. I don't even know how to
explain
it.
Mother-daughter chemistry or like a black people chemistry? What are we talking about?
I think a threesome chemistry. That's what he's trying to get at.
Oh, wasn't going towards that, but you know what?
Now that you
there was something weird a second ago, and I wasn't going to touch it because, you know, we don't want to talk about it.
You guys are shared dudes?
Hell no.
What? Why not?
I thought maybe that's what it was. I don't know.
No.
Ew. Yeah, that's a little too long with that note.
Someone was excited for Big Blue earlier when they walked in. We don't know who it was, but there was all kind of hooper and hollering. Now, she came with an entourage, and the entourage is sitting in the back. Do you guys have your headphones on? Oh, dude, you guys have headphones. Wait, what?
Oh, there's nothing coming out of the headphones.
Ah, shit. Okay, we'll figure that out.
Sorry about that.
Hearing things? Because I didn't hear anything either. Are you hearing things right now?
Oh.
No.
You might want to
right now.
Volume.
No.
No.
The other way.
She can hear you. Yeah.
What about
you
now?
Hearing things now?
No. What's up?
How are you answering me if you can hear anything?
No. Because she's hearing your regular voice,
I guess,
dude.
I should have them on both ears. Huh?
Wow. Yeah,
oh,
that's my daughter.
Now you hear something.
Can you tell that
are
I'm
you
singing?
High right now? You are high
she
as fuck right now.
Yeah,
high.
Dude. Fuck. All right, we're going to try to get our shit together for a minute. So here's some like weed music or
no,
whatever.
I think we can hear each other now.
Wait, what?
yeah, she can hear, but her friends can't. If you're going to try to get the friends like dialed in also, let's just take that break, and then we'll come back to it.
Shot a lemon drop, feeling really good with Patron on the rocks. Girls like that flavor, shots of the rock. I keep on pouring shots. Get them all fucked up. Get them all fucked up. Get them all fucked up. I'ma keep pouring shots to get them all fucked up. Get them all fucked up. Fucked up beyond the legal limit. They're getting off, break it to be specific. Them right there with the mani skirts. Let me take my pick, gonna go to work. She gonna get drilled, yeah, that's the deal. You can bring your friend with the blue high heels. Follow me, gonna be a hell of a time. Here's one more shot, shot, grab a line. DJ, turn up that mix, yeah, DJ. 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 Turn it up, turn it up, turn it up. DJ, turn up that mix, yeah, DJ. Turn up that mix, yeah, DJ. Some shots, gather round, let's take some shots. Gather round, let's do more shots. If you don't feel it now, wait a minute, just watch. Just watch. Just watch. Just watch. Turn it up, turn it up, turn it up, turn it up. DJ, turn up that mix, yeah, DJ. Turn up that mix, yeah, DJ. Turn up that mix, turn it up, turn it up, turn it up, turn it up. I'm taking that molly and I'm feeling this party. Girls getting naughty and the night is just starting. Molly and I'm feeling this party. Girls getting naughty and the night is just starting. I'm taking that Molly and I'm feeling this party. Girls getting naughty and the night is just starting. I'm taking that Molly and I'm feeling this party. Girls getting naughty and the night is just starting. DJ, turn up that mix, yeah, DJ. Turn up that mix, yeah, DJ. Turn up that mix, turn it up, turn it up, turn it up, turn it up. Turn up that mix, yeah, DJ. Turn up that mix, yeah, DJ. Turn up that mix, turn it up, turn it up, turn it up, turn it up. Gather round, let's pour some shots. Gather round, let's take some shots. Gather round, let's do more shots. If you don't feel it now, wait a minute, just watch. Just watch. Just watch.
La la ta ta ra ra. La ta ta. I was gonna clean my room until I got high. I was gonna get up and find the broom, but then I got high. My room is still messed up, and I know why.
Why, man?
Yeah, cause I got high. Because I got high. Because I got high. La da da. I was gonna go to class before I got high.
Come on, y'all.
Check it out.
I could have cheated and I could have passed, but I got high. La da. I'm taking it next semester and I know why.
Why, man?
Yeah, cause I got high. Because I got high. Because I got high.
Go to the next one. Go to the next one. Go to the next
one. I was gonna go to court before I got high. I was gonna pay my child support, but then I got high.
No, you wasn't.
They took my whole paycheck, and I know why.
Why, man?
Yeah, cause I got high. Because I got high. Because I got high. La da 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 da. I wasn't gonna run from the cops, but I was high.
I'm serious, man.
I was gonna pull right over and stop, but I was high. La da da. Now I'm a paraplegic and I know why.
Why, man?
Yeah, cause I got high. Because I got high. Because I got high. La da 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 da. I was gonna make love to you, but then I got high.
I'm serious.
I was gonna eat your too, but then I got high. Yeah, because I got high.
Hey, keep going.
Because I got high.
Hey, do that over,
because
man.
Because I
on.
Got high.
Hey, come on, man. Don't,
come on.
Come on.
Go. Go. I messed up my entire life because I got high.
Go.
I lost my kids and wife because I got high.
Say what? Say what? Say what? Say what?
Now I'm sleeping on the sidewalk and I know why.
Why, man?
Yeah, because I got high. Because I got high. Because I got high. La 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 da da da. I'ma stop singing this song because I'm high.
Present tense,
baby. I'm singing this whole thing wrong because I'm high.
Bring it back, bring it back.
And if I don't sell one copy, I'll know why.
Why, man?
Check out the new 4G phones.
the Sprint HTC EVO and the Sprint Samsung Epic are here. Both have flash players, so you can stream PX Radio live anywhere in the country. So if you're one of those out there having trouble getting your hands on one of these new, cool, special phones, call Arturo at the Signal Hill Sprint store. He's at 562-225-8443. That's Arturo at 562-225-8443. We welcome all new and existing customers.
Carlo's Pizza, family owned and operated in Downey since 1964. That's a long time, folks. Carlo's Pizza, where is it? Same place it's always been, 13230 Woodruff Avenue at Foster. Not only do we have great sandwiches, we got awesome pasta specials, but besides that, let me tell you something, folks. We got the best pizza around. You want to know how I know? Because I'm Italian and I love real, authentic Italian pizza. Where are you going to find that? I'll tell you where. Carlo's. No event is too big or too small. We do catering over here. That's what I'm talking about. We cook all the food. You eat all the food. You're going to love it. Let me tell you something. We also got delivery. You're at home. You're watching the playoffs. You don't want to leave the couch. Give Carlos a call. We're going to come over there and bring you some pizza at 562-803-6753. Oof, Maron. Well, our pizza is the best pizza in town. We got all kinds of sizes from little itty bitty all the way to a party size. It's almost 2 feet long. Maron, I'm talking about 2 feet long. That's a bigger pizza. You know what I'm saying? 562-803-6753. Carlos Pizza. Or we make a pizza you can't refuse.
Hey guys, if you want to step your game up, go to LibbyGrow.com now for your free sample of the best natural sexual enhancement product available. Find out why millions of men choose LibbyGrow when they want the fun to last and last. No order to place, no club to join, just a free sample. Go to LibbyGrow.com now to get your free sample. Not because you need it, because you want it.
Hello? Mr. Statham? Yes, this is him. I know we talked about getting you on Pigs Radio, but it is a little surprise you're on now. So if you don't mind saying hi to Mario and the best Jason Statham, can you just say, hey, babies, listen to Pigs Radio and Mario 81.
Listen, babies. Listen to Pigs Radio, Mario 81.
Watch me new movie.
Does he have a new movie?
Furious, he was in that shit. Yeah, isn't he a good guy now or some shit?
And the new one?
Yeah.
I haven't even seen
it. In case you guys don't know, we're chicks. What? And we love listening to Pigs Radio.
What's up, girl?
Welcome to Pigs Radio.
This is his favorite part of the song.
Everyone likes different things, and we think that's okay.
Different things.
But this is what we turn off the headphone real quick. So sit down and shut your mouth. Because it's time for us to share what Pigs is all about.
Poop. Later.
Pigs.
Fuck Jose. We are queer.
I think the mics were on the whole time.
Yeah.
No,
they were.
Because my friend was like,
never mind. Does anyone hear you? I don't think you can hear it. Maybe on that.
Yeah, maybe through the phone.
Pigs Radio. Let's try this once again. Episode 146. This is a really cool, exciting episode. We're going to learn everything there is to do about weed and weed stuff and more weed stuff. I mean, I don't know how much you can learn. So we did learn that you're a shop manager. They don't tell you shit. You just show up and sell fucking weed all day to fucking kids.
Slanging it back.
Yeah. Were you at that? You said for 3 years, right? At the dispensary? And that was
yeah,
at multiple
two ones? Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Are you at one right now?
No, I'm freeballing it right now. Ooh. I don't have
so
a job.
You're just not wearing any underwear?
You can't talk about Rona's kid like that.
I don't care.
Okay, then fuck it. Lay it on then.
What's the craziest edible you ever seen?
A 1,000 milligram brownie, which I partake in often.
1,000 milligram.
Are you high now? Because you got real chinky eye shit going.
Oh,
on.
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
Okay, just making sure. Just making sure.
We actually do have chinky eyes, but they're really way lower than they
like,
are.
How many milligrams?
Konnichiwa.
How big of a dose does it take for you to get high? I mean, not you personally, but people in general.
Are you like on Snoop Dogg's level yet? Like, I don't even know what level that is. Like. A billion?
That's a level you can't go back from.
So. You think so?
Yeah.
No, your tolerance is shot. Yeah.
That sucks, though. Like, that means you need to, like,
stay
overwork your smoking at that point just to get
You gotta,
minimum.
Like, stop, which sucks because it's like you gotta let your tolerance go
down.
He
shoots up the TAC.
Yeah.
No. She injected the marijuanas.
No, no, nobody does that.
She's so stoned right now. I love it. This is great. All right, so in within those 3 years, two different shops, what has been like the most craziest thing that you've actually seen go down in there?
Lots of fights, honestly.
Really? In between who?
I thought stoners were supposed to be like calm
peaceful.
People.
Well, they don't have it. That's why they're cranky and they're on their way to the store.
Give me my fixed.
They're supposed to be, but a lot of them are alcoholics.
What?
Yeah. They come in like...
Already fucked
up. Crossfaded?
Yeah.
Damn.
And they'll like argue with us about prices and stuff. And it's like, I don't know. Like, I don't argue about bacon prices. Why are you arguing with me about weed prices?
Maybe
like,
you should argue about bacon prices.
I want to argue about bacon
prices.
Like, I can go to
wait, can you even eat bacon?
Yes.
Okay, just make sure.
I
want
to know why
$8 a packet.
Applewood smoked bacon is so expensive.
The nicer ones.
But it's so amazing, though.
It is
Applewood.
Delicious.
Free range.
I just buy it.
Bacon.
I don't know. I
Costco has
weed,
decent
but
bacon.
I don't ask questions.
That Kirkland bacon, the thick cut?
Yeah, thick cut. Always thick cut.
I made some of that
thick like your mama.
So
not, wait, okay, actually.
She's a little thick, though.
A little bit now. But in the good way.
Always in a good way. Thick size.
Thick is good.
Thick. So in between those fights, what are they all about? I mean, like we're talking about actual like fist fights and shit, like.
Not fist
like
fights.
Somebody bogarted the joint or some shit?
No, no, no. It's always about pricing. It's always been about pricing.
So like, you're telling me the people that come and buy weed are usually poor or are maybe under government help?
Section 8?
No, nobody got that. Okay. I said some of them.
Some of them.
Like
some
all of them.
No.
Like all.
What city have those dispensaries been in?
I've worked in Gardena, and I've also worked in West Hollywood, so I've seen both spectrums.
Damn, WeHo. Then be a lot of gays out there.
Very high-priced
gays. Wait, okay, so all the fights are happening out there, right? All the faggots are just like, no!
No!
Too much!
No, I have had an old lady, like, almost swat me before, and I almost punched that bitch. Cause
she swat at you? Why?
Yeah, because
what'd you do?
No, because she
Liar.
Said she had a... Fuck you. She said she got a $20 discount or a 20% discount and I assessed it and it was before taxes and out in WeHo.
Okay, that's a valid point. It might have been on a Tuesday. That's normally senior day everywhere else, like Ross and shit.
I don't give a shit.
But it's senior day.
No.
God.
Go die.
The
bitch.
Weed industry is ruthless.
I gave you
oh my
your
God.
Fucking 20%. It was before taxes. You have to pay taxes. I don't care. Like, I have to pay taxes on this shit, and I work here.
There
so.
You
wait, you guys tax on weed?
Yeah. West
absolutely.
Hollywood
how else are you going to make money off of it?
They got to collect the state tax. They're doing it legit.
No, but the state's actually collecting on that?
Yeah,
dude,
they
Colorado.
Why
know,
wouldn't they?
The reason
why
it's
wouldn't
so
they?
Profitable is because you can tax it.
Everything's oh, taxed. No. Plus, they double the price on everything.
Yeah.
Everything in a shop is half price. I guarantee
imagine
you
if they legalized heroin, they could tax the shit out of it, how much money we'd make.
Maybe. You'll be dead.
Well, how much
you'll
broke you would
no!
be.
No!
I mean, it would weed out other.
No.
I don't do heroin.
Yeah, I don't think it would
but
apply.
But people that do could get
my
it legally.
My friend.
It wouldn't be my it wouldn't be such a big of a market since everybody's probably ODing.
Good. It's like
is that like weeding out the tar?
Yeah, it's you're weeding out. It's you know you're it's survival of the fittest. Number one, if you're dumb enough to do it, you die. Okay, great.
But you
don't have
to
feed you anymore. I think it's a great idea.
I think she's gonna fucking shoot up heroin in your butt
you
when you're not looking.
Lose out our repeat customers. How do you keep growing the business if they just
no, I mean, if it dies out, it dies out.
I mean,
it's like tobacco.
People breed every day.
It's capitalism.
Okay, you guys are Breaking Bad this whole shit like way out of proportion. We're talking about fucking weed. We don't care about fucking Ronnie's fucking shit she does on a Tuesday night.
Like
we know you're a fucking junkie. We get it. Yes. Fuck. I want to hear about the weed. The shit that you don't like. Because, I don't know. Why don't you like weed?
It's affected me negatively before.
Like how? Did it touch you in weird places you didn't belong?
Kind of. Like
you put it there?
The bad parts of my brain. It like
oh,
opened up the
brain.
Bad parts of my brain.
What did it do? Like,
what
are
you
like mind
Indica
you?
Or sativa?
Some Compton shit.
It's
huh?
probably
you know what? It was like some fucking like $10
sativa,
for whatever it was back in like middle school, high school.
Oregano?
Yeah, it multiple times. It was probably oregano.
Yeah. Right up grass.
Hey, Paco, sell me some of your weed and shit. Paco
was,
gave some fucking oregano.
I think his name was Javier or something.
Of course it was. Yeah. Of course.
Yeah. And he also
he
was also
cilantro.
Dealing other things as well.
Some thyme, some basil.
And
some
I've
aspirin.
Tried legal weed. I've tried legal weed, too. It's really strong, and it's probably worse because it
does he
like
still
takes
slang?
Me there worse.
Javier?
I mean,
can we have his number?
The legal weed is better because they strained out all the little weeds and stems from the 80s.
Probably.
It's a much better strain, so it probably hits you in places that you never thought.
Oh, yeah, and it's like,
could.
Probably, but it's always been negative. Like, yeah, it's always been like, oh, nobody wants me around. I need to go die in a hole.
Oh,
let
me
go kill myself.
Oh, you don't get, like, paranoid? Like, I get paranoid.
That's part of
I
it, too.
I get paranoid.
Part of it, too.
Yeah,
but my paranoia, like, we talked about this before. Yeah. My paranoia is different from yours. You think you're going to die. I think I'm about to, like, get kicked out of places because nobody wants me there.
It'll exacerbate your problems.
I get depressed.
So, honestly, you shouldn't smoke if you have.
Thank you. I mean, thank you.
No, if you
Instead
have mental
this
issues
here,
that you
I'm
can't
not pushing
work
anything
through,
down your throat.
It can exacerbate them.
No, yeah. You're just making, like, you're making me feel bad for not wanting to partake
oh
in your
my
stupid
God.
Devil's cabbage, lettuce, whatever.
No, like, see, my problem with weed, you know, the reason I don't smoke is because I always
hell
felt
kale.
Like it's like people. Hell kale.
Hell kale.
Thank you.
Hell kale, yeah.
It sounds like something that they saw at Jamba Juice and shit. Let me get a hell kale.
Can I
and
get
a grande
shot of
or
the
fucking
ginger
venti.
And some hell
but
kale.
My problem is that I just feel paranoid kale. In the sense that I think everybody's looking at me. Like, you know, when
yeah.
I high, I'm all of a sudden like everybody's
You are the
me.
Tallest guy in the room.
You gotta smoke some indica then.
Everyone's always looking at you.
Everyone's looking at me. They don't want me here. That's the path I go through.
It's not that they don't want me here. I'm like, why are they always looking at me?
It's probably the
definitely
satanic,
should not smoke
satanic circle on
ever.
Your back.
No.
You know?
If you have anxiety, you know,
yeah. It's the middle finger.
I'm already on anxiety meds.
It's the
so
finger, the middle finger you're flicking up at everybody. That's probably
and
what it is.
You should probably look into CBDs, honestly.
I've been told that
here.
By this guy as well.
Yeah.
CBD?
Because
it doesn't get you high.
It's the psychoactive part of the marijuana.
So you don't get high.
You
don't get high.
Actual,
yeah,
you can't say
benefits.
That you don't get high because everyone is different. So you can have slightly high effects, but it would not be as strong as smoking.
So my
now.
Day off is next Friday. Can you come hang? We're about to go to
yeah.
Take some samples.
Yeah.
Well, she's in between shops right now, guys. But as soon as she gets her, hopefully she'll let
free
us.
Bong.
And then you
free
can get
bongs.
CBD at anywhere. You don't have to get it from a shop. Yeah.
No, I'd say get it from a shop. Only
I think like Whole Foods sells
more,
it.
The CBD section at Whole Foods, yeah, for sure.
Yeah.
Organic?
It's CBD. Definitely organic. But no, most shops will
vegan
have CBDs.
And everything. Gluten free, okay?
I want to get some of that free range
and
CBD.
And I don't really want to have my old job, but MedMen has a lot of good CBDs, but you know.
That's put it on its ground without its will, okay?
All right, so what's been the most dangerous situation you've been at the weed shop?
No gun point?
Has there been a raid?
Honestly,
or
I've never had
a
no guns?
Okay,
a raid or robbery?
I did get off like an hour and a half before the last shop that I worked at got raided, but I was
you
never
said got raided?
Raided, yeah.
By the police?
Yeah,
the
like
feds.
They were standing on the corner with handcuffs lined up. Like,
and you had just walked out?
Yes. Like an hour
on your
before.
Way to check
yeah.
the box
oh,
to
shit.
Get a munchie
she
meal.
Was,
yeah, I got that.
She wasn't
like,
wearing a mic.
They have.
She wasn't wearing a mic saying, I am out.
Wink.
What,
wink.
Like, what right did they have to
the
do
bird
that?
Abracadabra.
Getting licenses is a very difficult process. And to be completely legal, you have to have certain licenses that I don't even know all of the ins and outs of. So I can't really tell you, but it's really expensive.
Okay, so that shop didn't have it?
No, yeah. A lot of them don't. Oh. A lot of them just don't have all of the legal.
They run free
fully
ball.
Fully legal.
Really?
Not
so they just pop
ball.
Up shop
they
and just start
like
selling until they get
half free ball.
They have like jocks.
Just like one ball out. Half ball.
Now, there are pictures of Underdog's balls out there. We have to hit up the Badger, and we can get those for the internet. You ready to get those
that
out?
That was the best reaction, by the way. She goes.
No buzz.
No buzz.
Low hanging fruit.
So, what? How many different strands
very
did
low.
You guys carry in your actual shops?
At the Gardena one, it was probably like 30. At West Hollywood, it was 40 plus. And then at the little shit shop that I worked at in San Pedro, it was like 12, maybe 20.
So did you guys also do the whole what's the dabbing stuff the liquid
the wax
form. The wax yeah the wax okay
dab wax is like a even stronger extracted version of marijuana so they extract all of the THC out of the flower
so it's just the THC or all the crystal that you see on the flower
pretty much yes yeah, the crystals and trimes that fall off the flower they put it together and it's
they make it they turn to liquid
usually
form.
Like 10 to 50% stronger than flour.
So it's still like I know you don't burn it like with a lighter. I know you it melts and no, kind yeah. of the vape the like vapor that comes it, off right? of it, right?
You torch it usually, yeah. yeah.
So this sounds like heroin, guys. I'm not liking this at all.
Well, my question is crack
addict. Why does it always go back to heroin?
Crack addict with a pookie. Like,
yeah.
It's gonna kind of yeah, it could melt anywhere, right? It's like depending on the heat. It's like
no, yeah.
No, well, here's my question about it though. Does it still smell like weed though, or it doesn't when you're burning it?
It does smell like weed. It just won't smell like weed for as long of a.
It's just not as pungent or as strong. Okay.
That shit sounds scary.
Like,
I don't
understand why people just don't
do
that.
It is scary.
You know what I mean?
First time I dabbed, I, like, honestly, we were supposed to go to the beach, and I realized, like, why do I even smoke weed? Like, I don't understand why.
Great
I'm
parenting here.
Doing this to me. No, okay, yeah, I mean, she wasn't there. Yet.
She was whispering. She was whispering in her ear.
She was.
Oh, okay.
That's a partner in crime over there, so I'm not in that.
So the influence then, right here, see? Oh, evil powers combined.
So you like you dab what like 9 in the morning and then Lexi, you know, it was like 6 in the afternoon. You're like, what the fuck happened?
No, it was like 3 and then it was 3:15 and it was 3:17 and I realized like I can't do this. I can't go anywhere else. I have to go home and I had to pick my dog up and get the fuck out of there because I had to like calm myself down because at that level of THC, it messes with your brain. It gives you that paranoia.
One of my coworkers went to the ER because she was tripping so bad, and they put her on IV fluids.
Wow, you too?
And they were like, epic. You're fine. They're like, you're fine. You just, you know, you need to calm down. You put her on fluids, and then they're like, you're leaving in 2 hours. That's it.
You're high, bitch.
She was high. She was
go
tripping.
Home.
You high
eat
as
some
fuck,
Cheetos
bitch.
And shut the fuck up.
Stop by Jack the Box.
Yeah, roll by
get those.
Jack
get those $2 get those $1 for 2 tacos.
By the way, exciting news. And
get the number 3 extra large.
The exciting news right now.
Onion rings.
For the stoners out there, there's an app now for, I think, Double Dash or some shit that Jack in the Box is delivering to your house now.
Shut the fuck up.
I'm a stoner and I'm excited.
Yes.
It's like Grubhub.
Yes.
Yeah. Taco Bell tried that shit, I remember.
So
they're going bankrupt.
Sure
Postmates is like the number one app for fucking like.
What about your Postmate?
Oh. It's meant for you.
Oh,
because you're such a like, you know.
Postmate?
It's like pastrami.
Sure. I do like, you know what? I do love pastrami.
You can get it. It's just like people just, like, you just tell people, oh, I want this, and this from this place, and then somebody just brings it
somebody
to your home.
Somebody will just go get it and
like Uber Eats.
Yeah. Like, it's kind of like Uber Eats, but
intern?
For anything. Like, you can tell them, oh, I want the fucking gummy worms from 7-Eleven, and they'll go get it. You pay, like, insane amounts of money, but you get it, and you don't have
I
to
mean,
leave your house.
I don't know, man. Would you trust somebody just to go get you some shit? You know what I mean?
It's on the app.
Probably put his balls on it and shit.
I think I've dealt with something like that. Some guy came up to me and asked me, hey, this person's looking for this. He says,
I'm going to lure you to this room, kid.
Okay. Yeah. This guy's looking for this iPhone.
At the electronics store that we work at, which is some random electronics store, people come in all the time, and it's always like, oh, like, I just need this cable and that cable. And it's for this customer. And I was like, oh, okay. Like, we just... Oh, you know who else gets Postmates? Is Hustler. Nice. People who don't want to go into Hustler because they don't want to be seen inside, like, a sex shop will have people go in, buy a certain
toy.
They're
just lazy.
Even
can you fuck them when they deliver the
what
stuff?
What if the guy doesn't want to go in?
Yeah. Oh, okay.
He's debating outside.
Well, it's a job.
I guess.
Yeah. Of course it is.
I guess.
You pay for it.
I feel like if you want to get off, you might as well just go inside.
True. I mean, I want to touch the toys, you know.
Well, I think we need to give her a mic. She is very like.
She wants to sample them out.
You know, maybe.
Hey, you know what? Why don't you pull up? Pull your chair up.
Oh, come on.
How hard would it be to get her a mic?
But I was going to suggest this such a long time ago. Right. She's so funny.
Take a break.
You guys need
get a
to
mic.
Have her up here.
All right, yeah. Let's take a quick break and we'll be right back with more fucking weed. And by the way, I have Seth Rogen. What video, Seth Rogen? Showing you how to fucking roll a joint, so that's gonna be interesting.
Oh.
So
she used to come. Oh, he used to come into our shop.
Which
really?
One? The
which one?
Well,
he goes to my hospital.
Probably. He does not go to Gardena.
No, not Gardena. West Hollywood.
Oh, okay, just making sure.
Pluggy Medmen again.
We
I still miss them.
Wait. All right, there's some. Hold on. Let's see. What can we?
I miss you.
Oh, I don't know what's going on, but
Hi, Ronnie. Sorry, he's on my face.
She's on your Facebook? Is she stalking you?
Oh, my God.
It's a boy.
Am I high? I just thought she told me hi, Ronnie, and I'm like, her mouth did not move. What?
It's Pete.
And you don't sound like a white girl. Like, what?
You just dabbed. You didn't know it, but we just dabbed your beer.
Hey, baby, you on drugs?
We put some dab in
your beer. Did I eat marijuana?
Yes.
Possibly. We slipped it in your beer.
Oh, my God. Mm-hmm.
Your titties in the air, if they're small, we don't care. I've been drinking, so I'm drunk. Your titties be looking plump. Chris Thomas sucking nipples, love them titties, plain and simple.
There's a lot of things happening
right now.
There's
microphones in front of you, ladies. Let's talk about it. I don't know. Is there a volume control for headphones?
Her headphones should still work.
Underdog.
Underdog.
Hey,
we are not on our A game today.
Best blowjob. Best blowjob.
What do you mean, best blowjob?
What's the best blowjob you ever got?
Contest?
Where were you at?
It was recently.
Oh, yeah?
I'm asking because I'm so dry in the blowjob region. You know what I mean?
It was during the pictatrophy.
By the way, that's a random question to ask out of the blue. Hey, best blowjob, go.
Because the song, Jimmy, the song's talking about you can't smell your dick and all that shit. So while they're down there smelling,
my friend
you
asked,
well
like, what's
it.
Up with those songs?
Yeah.
Can we get deets?
They're just awesome songs to play.
Oh, they are awesome. Yeah.
See?
Blowjob song.
Do you guys hear that shit anywhere else? No,
exactly.
Only on Pigs Radio.
That's right.
So for all the people listening, make sure you guys go to pigsradio.com for all Pigs news related, upcoming guests, the past podcast episodes and video links and shit. So pigsradio.com. So once again, if you guys have a question for the shop people, the people who like to smoke weed or I don't know, whatever, questions of life, call in at 909-475-7449. We'll take your bullshit fucking calls.
Q&P, best blowjob.
Obviously, with her.
What's up?
Yeah. By the way, he like points.
I tell them like I'd rather him be truthful. Like I'm not gonna ask him anything
like
I don't want to hear.
Do you bite when you do a blowjob?
No.
All right, here I was single for a good amount of time.
Why do you start off with that? That's
let me preface this by.
And I gotta say she was at the verge of walking out of my life, and I said, you know what, I'm keeping this one
for not doing blowjobs or for doing blowjobs.
Why?
Or bad blowjobs.
It was all in general. It was all in general, man. I was
car blowjobs.
Oh shit.
Driving blowjobs.
Car jobs.
I love driving blowjobs.
I didn't have
any. Roadhead people.
Roadhead. Public blowjobs.
I want to cry.
Break
blowjobs.
The alley. Right behind the alley.
Break blowjobs.
Wait.
Just like, hey, come
outside.
Yeah. I'm on break. You on break too? Okay.
Wait, you have a mic. You have a mic.
It's low.
Okay. It's low. Turn it up, motherfucker.
How about now?
Hello.
Yeah.
Hi.
Hey, what's up? Jive turkey in the house.
Jive turkey.
She really just plugged.
I know. That's my Instagram. Don't follow, though. It's like
Jive turkey. Follow that shit. I'm about to follow that shit.
Blow that shit up. Blow that shit up.
All right, so you're here to give insight on the weed, or you're just part of the entourage? Are you, like, protecting her from something?
She used to be a customer, apparently.
Myself. Mostly these fuck niggas, yeah, and herself.
You protect her from herself?
Please yeah, do. I try.
Aww.
Yeah. Right? Ride or die.
Friends.
Like day ones, as they call it these days.
Actually,
the
no, day one, I did not like her.
Day one,
like, fuck that bitch.
No, yeah,
wow.
Really though, yeah.
I fought her friend in high school.
That's ooh. That was my first memory. Like this bitch is fucking on my friend. Like she fucked her. Yeah.
So you went to the more dominant friend, is what happened. Like oh shit, she can protect
me.
I like that.
Yeah.
I gotta roll with that one.
I'm gonna lay low, but when you're ready to strike, bam, take over.
The new pack leader.
Honestly, though, yeah. Yeah, really though, because I'm like, the more passive one.
You're
like,
the beta.
I'm not gonna fuck you up without notice, but her, like, I'm usually the one like, Ash, let's assess the situation. Come on, like,
let's talk to fuck some
she's
bitches up.
I'm like, what, bitch? What? Like,
bitch said what?
Please turn this side. So
your mama a hoe. Like,
yeah. Fuck.
Yeah. I mean, it's true.
Yeah, is it is. Not?
No, I literally have screenshots from this morning of her going in on somebody. She's like, I think I had too much C4 this morning.
C4?
What the hell?
That's my pre-workout. Out, yeah.
What the fuck is C4?
It's a workout. It's a pre-workout.
It's a workout?
Basically a bunch of like fucking...
I mean,
should that mean
like crack?
It's a
meth.
Workout.
It's
like half a step.
I'm walking in the gym
steroids.
And I'm like,
it's legal crack. Honestly, it gives you jitters. I was in the
your
gym like, legitimately. Right. I was like, 3 half breaths away from passing out and having an asthma attack.
But that should not make you stop.
I was hitting that heavy bag like that was. No
Or at least you think you were in like real life. You're like looking like Pete and shit. Fucking all weird and dumb. Like,
don't hurt my self-esteem. I'm
bitch.
Still C4.
And what makes you think I'm like...
He lured me in. Like, just all weird shit.
Fucking pimp took all my money. Took all my
he had nothing to take.
He had nothing to take. Not even the pride. That was long gone.
You're absolutely right. You have no fucking pride.
That was before TJ, though.
That was before TJ.
Hence the long.
That shit's cold as fuck. That shit was cold as fuck, dude. The girl didn't even fucking spat it out. It's like, she spat it out like it was Cuban's pink jizz and shit.
Hope you're happy. Now she went to go cry, Pino. Fuck,
she did it to herself.
Aw. Oh.
What happened here?
Well, I guess there's no wedding.
Hey, it was good. It was good while it lasted, right? Yeah. You still got the pictures. Oh no, you don't. You lost the phone.
Oh my god!
iCloud.
Except for he forgot
sorry,
to log
guys.
In though.
It's always on.
Are we good, Mark?
So are you okay, my dear? Like, did he upset you?
Just cute shit.
Okay, just making sure. We got alarmed. We thought you were going to plant.
Was it a cool shot that you had to spit
you
out?
You have some beer on your forehead.
That's not beer.
Oh, man.
Oh.
It's moisturizer.
Okay, so what are some things that we should not be doing once we get our card, wherever we get those things from? Walk into the shop. I'm like, is there a good form of etiquette? Like, yeah. Is there a bad form of etiquette?
Because I can get weed now.
Girl, I dance everywhere I go. So, yeah, dance.
Dancing is welcome because our days suck.
If you're buying you
sell weed all day. How does your day suck?
They don't like that.
Because I deal with stupid people all day.
Oh, you mean just the public?
Yeah.
Okay. Cool.
That's any retail environment. So do you guys have like little baskets on the way in and shit, where you like fucking drop your little like fucking purple haze or something?
Actually, at MedMen, yeah, we had shopping baskets.
No way.
MedMen was like it had iPods that you could go in and order your shit off of.
Don't talk highly of them.
I'm sorry. I don't like them anymore.
I'm kidding. They're great.
MedMen is a
great company.
The Whole Foods.
They just fucked up with a real one. Is all that happened? Like they're still a great company. They just lost a real one.
I don't know what's happening. There's like gang signs and.
So what happened? You invite black people to the show.
I am scared.
What's up? Don't get shot.
I don't care anymore. I'm
well,
black.
He's pretty black. That's why he's a mystery nigga. Like, really black. Like, the blackest.
He's actually blacker than me. It's
that's why he understands really what's going on, and you're here questioning shit.
I know. I don't understand.
Hello.
Get the tala.
Just let him flow, fool. Just let him flow.
It's like, is this a new language? What is this?
It's not Ebonics.
Right, I was just going to say, it's what they call Ebonics, right?
What?
Ooh.
E40, Bay Area. No?
Okay, but seriously. Yeah, that's my daughter.
So what happened at the hospital?
Yeah, so what
how are you going to bring that
I
up?
I don't know. Wait. We were talking about
just
the
because
etiquette.
You go with Cuban Pete, you got to bring me down.
Okay,
huh?
So first of all, let me start this story because
go ahead,
I got
we'll
called back to that. At 6:45 in the morning and told to get on the bus in the opposite direction to come pick up my mother.
It was 7.
Also, you're the culprit, though, for like sharing? And didn't you work at the
No. I told her exactly. I told her exactly how much to take.
And I took
and
that
decided, much. And she decided, oh, it's not working quickly enough.
It was a quarter piece
so
of chocolate.
You done goofed,
first
Rona?
Thing they tell you.
Don't call me Rona.
That's the
Mama Rona?
Okay.
That's the first thing they tell you. Don't take more. Don't take more.
Okay, so what had happened was, I took a little bit of too big a piece of, what was that really good chocolate?
Kiva.
And I got to work. And I was looking at this order, which had the same numbers on it, but they were different somehow.
I wish you could see her eyes.
And I was looking at it, and then it became clear. I was like super focused, and I was like putting in 12 orders at the same time. And then it became really bad again. And then I was like, oh, shit, they know. Kind of like mystery nigga. They know. That's so it. I was like, Ashley. I was whispering on my phone, Ashley.
Literally.
Come and get me, they know.
And I'm on the bus.
And
know?
I just, yeah. She's on the bus going to work.
I've smoked on the way to work. I'm ready to go.
Right? Are you ready?
And then I get called.
You got to come pick your mom up from work. They know.
Ashley, come pick me up. I think I took too much.
She's like, Ma, you're fine. No, they know. Hurry up before they find out.
I tried to save her this ER visit.
I couldn't. I wasn't having it. I was not having it. Take me to ER. I think I'm going to die.
What? You think. That's it. But
you know when you in the moment thinking real,
your brain is very powerful.
I've got to the ER thinking I'm gonna die, and it's
and
like
this was my
you're
first
stupid,
trip.
Bro, get the fuck out of here.
There were no aliens. There was nothing legally going on.
So
I was
to
literally
sit.
Gonna die.
I had to sit.
And she, I love how she told the doctor. She looked at the doctor and said, "She's had a little too much," and he was like, okay, we'll go ahead and discharge
her. Bring her some chocolate, and she'll be fine.
Take her ass home is basically what he said in nice doctor terms.
So I had to miss 3 hours of work.
But I love you,
Joe.
Because
she didn't want to listen to me, because I just told her to take a nap.
And
by the way, how much did that cost you just to fucking for a little fuck up like that?
Sick time?
Sick time. Okay, cool.
Yeah, it was cool.
I didn't use
it. But that was like one of the best naps ever.
Woke up for like refreshed. Like
I was like
wow.
Damn, I was felt like I was 25 again.
It's okay. Spring again.
I felt like I was 40 because I.
You had to come and be the mama.
Stressed out because my mom's a nut.
I was a nut before the too much chocolate, so that's okay. It's on paper. But
so with the bar, with the place, with the etiquette, do people come up to you and ask you a bunch of questions like that? Like, hey, how much is way too much, or how much should I not be eating? I'm like, no, fuck it, eat it all. Like,
how much is way too much actually? What your mom took, but I mean, how much is way too much?
If you've never taken edibles, yeah. I'd say 15 milligrams. Take 15 milligrams, sit down.
Writing that down right now.
Get closer to the mic.
Yeah, nice.
15 milligrams. Like, I don't know what's going on, but I like it.
Yeah, that was awesome.
Yeah, 15 milligrams for beginners. I should only take like 100 milligrams. I usually take like 500 milligrams sometimes.
I think that's like beyond Snoop Dogg level, right?
That guy that came in with the, what are they called?
The Michelada Cuts for 420 out of San Diego?
Yeah, there you go.
Those
there
are 200.
200 milligrams?
Yeah.
So no wonder all you motherfuckers are passed the fuck out at the
allegedly.
End of the show.
Allegedly.
There's pictures of you fucking laying on the fucking floor. That's how fucked up you were.
Allegedly. No, I was pretty fucked up. I don't know. I don't. I can't do edibles. I can't gauge them right, and I just get sick.
No, yeah.
Like when
like
you went to San Diego?
Yeah, it was just that triggered my fucking anxiety to a whole different level, and I fucking
there's a difference between smoking and eating because the process of digestion actually makes it so much stronger than it is when you inhale it. So that was one of my problems too.
Yeah, I mean,
because she's ever inhaled
before.
Oh no, she has. I was there for it. It was hilarious. It did not go well.
Was that with Johnny?
Yeah, we tried to smoke that joint that one time.
Was
it
a similar
event?
I'm dying. Was it the same thing? Similar effect?
No, it was. We could physically see that she was dying this time. It was like.
She got the
and
cough.
We like just lit the joint. I mean, like,
she didn't even like puff yet.
Give me a pull.
Like, right, I'm look, like, get it past your mouth.
Nancy Reagan was very smart, very hard on us about that stuff back in the 80s. Okay, I didn't want to inhale.
Come on, guys. There was a thing called Dare, right? I think it was Dare.
Thank you. I love how it's the kids though, like, mom, just smoke the fucking
Nancy
weed.
Reagan.
God,
for real though. I took her out.
Oh God, I forgot about that one.
Cause she and I was like, just inhale, like,
just pull it in.
Just like, inhale, like.
Just take it.
And I felt really stupid, like,
trying to teach
your
mom
how
to inhale on a
inhale. But it was like, into your lungs. Like, don't
I
hold
can't.
It in your mouth. I was like.
I mean, did you ever, Rona, did you ever smoke, like, cigarettes?
Never.
I mean, oh, okay. So
that's
you really didn't know. You really
never had a pack of Newports? What?
Oh, God.
Bitch, please. Newports are for black people.
Okay, no, just cool.
I'm staring you down, homie.
Virginia Slims, no Benson Hedges.
Oh, we had Virginia Slims. That was a Virginia Slim.
There you go. There you go. Yeah, I know.
Those were the fancy
I've always loved
myself. Oh, yeah. Top shelf shit.
I'm kidding. You don't have to hate yourself to smoke cigarettes. That's a joke that I make.
I think he hates himself enough.
So do you ever get any kind of like crazy new timers that actually come down that don't know anything about weed, but then they recently got hurt and they're like, oh, I better go try this. I'll sign up.
I heard that Cypress Hills record and I'd like to fucking get high.
I would feel those patients that like don't really smoke. Oh, okay. Well,
they're the worst.
I love the people that discover weed and like, oh my God, I was so hateful before, but it's like saving my life. And it's like, you're
I do
right,
yoga.
Bitch. Oh God.
Okay. Yeah. Some of them are awesome.
I'm a pressed juiced girl.
But other people, they want the strongest shit and they can't handle it. They can't really.
Actually, no, I can handle it though.
Literally, I've had somebody come back into the shop like, is this weed or is this other stuff? Like, I was like, you said you wanted the strongest stuff in here, and this was like my beginning days. So I gave.
They're
him like,
did you
like
sprinkle a little lean on it? I mean, what are you fucking mean, bitch? That's
why
is that angel
the bath salt?
I think it was like my third day, and he came in like, this is my first time in a shop, and I just want the strongest stuff. So I gave him the $50.
I do the perks, girl. Hook me up.
It wasn't that far. But I gave him the $50 gram, and it was like. Maybe an hour and a half later, he came
he's
in.
Crawling
like,
into the building.
Exactly. He didn't have a shirt on, though. This is legit.
You know, he probably sat in his car for all that time.
Started sweating.
Underdog, why didn't you fucking
he
go
just
back
sniffed
in?
It.
Totally the underdog.
No, she would have said that he still had his shirt on. On
yeah,
the
I was
going
to say, how would she know if he took his shirt off or not? You can't tell.
Like way too much hair.
It's
way
same.
Too much hair.
Why did you take your shirt off? Or why did you put a sweater on? Shave that shit into a polo. Shave the little hard.
Wait, you guys want to see him? With a sweater? No.
I ate already.
His logo's a nipple.
Yeah. One time we wanted to see his nipple, and then he was taking his shirt off. We're like, wait, why are you not taking your shirt off? It's still on.
His undershirt.
This is an undershirt.
It was pretty gross.
The shirt before the shirt.
I'm hairy.
Should take some of that hair.
He went in with the wearing a t-shirt.
Wait, this video?
My mom always talks about me because Seth Rogen is like totally video my kind of dude. Just like he looks like
he's a Jew.
Much, you get up close to him, you're like, oh, he smells so good. This was like totally worth getting close to you.
Yeah, but he doesn't tip.
Yeah.
Now rolling joints.
That's a lie.
I'm like, who said that? Because we know.
I'm gonna walk you through this as though you've never even attempted this in your entire life.
Just to make sure. Is this a weed tutorial?
Yeah. It's actually gonna teach you how to roll a joint. All right. I don't want you guys to tell me if this is valid or not.
I think you need to turn it up a little bit or something.
If it's valid.
And marijuana. All right. Now, the reason you need a grinder is because when you buy weed, it comes like this in a bud.
Now it does. Not back in the day, though.
Bud,
man.
It won't smoke properly. In order to grind up your weed, you open your grinder, put your weed in it, close up your grinder.
That's accurate information.
Grind it around. And boom.
I'm more like a break down my nug.
And you don't want to grind your weed too much, or else it'll turn to powder and your joints will be fucked. Rolling paper has two ends. The shiny part is the gluey end. You're going to lick that later to seal up your joint, just like you lick an envelope. What I like to do is take my rolling paper and rip kind of a curved edge off the bottom of it like this.
Grab scissors.
I do this for two reasons. One is most rolling papers are too big, and I like to smoke as little paper as humanly possible. Other reason is for me, it makes the joints a little easier to roll, and you'll see why in a moment. Now, my friends, we're ready to start rolling. What I do is I take these three fingers, and I lay them flat. Yes. I put the glue end away from me, the torn edge towards me, lay them on my fingers, press my thumb in, and I create what I will now refer to as a small canoe out of my rolling paper. So, you take your canoe.
I thought it was going to be called something else better.
Weed into the bottom of it.
Something.
You should err on putting too much weed into it, because some weed's going to fall out as you roll it, and that's okay. It's also just easier to roll with more weed than less weed. Now, at this point, you pinch the top of the joint shut. You start to take your thumbs, and you roll the weed into the bottom of the paper. As you can see, I'm trying to compress the weed into the bottom of the rolling paper.
Do you agree with the juice so far?
Yes. Besides ripping the
open
joint,
it up and
it's like
in, and look, what? You've got packed in tube of weed just sitting.
Well, so
you
just
he has weed in the canoe, guys.
And now comes the hardest part. Holding over of the lower lip into the joint.
Sounds epic.
Now, you roll it back, tuck that underneath the paper, the ripped edge helps, roll it up, leaving only your little gluey end exposed. Now,
yeah, that you think you have a better Manny going on.
I like that part.
I kind of like it.
That
now.
Was nice.
Yeah.
All of a sudden, look at it.
Got a little sexy.
No wonder I heard a splash.
Kind of a loose joint, open on both ends. Now going to do, pinch shut one end, and you rotate it. Pinch, and you rotate. So now we have a joint sealed up on one end, and open on the butt end. Now's where our little cardboard filter comes into play. Take your filter, just like long version of your joint, twist it under, and you roll.
So you ripped your rolling
roll. Now, if you're going to roll it, roll it smaller than the joint, because if you've done it in the curl, it will expand into the size of your joint.
What?
That's
magic. Yeah, that's pretty easy.
You might be asking,
it's fucking magic, guys.
It makes sure the end of your joint doesn't fall apart from people slobbering all over it. And also means you can smoke it right down to the very end without burning your fingers.
Yeah, oh. Makes sense.
Both of which are good.
Kind of the fucking
before you light your joint, you might want to do what me
let's roll the joint, dude. We should do like a little joint class. Like,
really, really
joint.
Good at it. For
everybody
a
get your papers. You know how they have
you're
those classes for like older biddies and shit? Older women?
My mom
fucking
goes to that.
Older, older biddies?
Oh, I'm sorry. Okay.
She's a bitch, but
so,
not an older
okay,
biddy.
An older bitch. So you know how they have like, the wine classes where they give you like a canvas to paint on and it's just a wine tasting
instead,
and painting class?
Instead, you roll
weed. Yeah, let's do that with roll weed.
I would say
that
for our generation, they will.
But I actually want to get high, so like that little piece of baby joint isn't going to do anything.
How fat are your fucking joints?
We call them personals, and they're
they're called personals.
Are they the big Jamaican ones? The ones with like fucking like a football on one hand and shit. Like
I used to roll blunts, and everybody used to ask me why I used to roll them so fast, but I didn't know how to roll them like
anything.
Like Seth Rogen. Because we were children and reckless. Now we're all about conservation because we pay for our own weed. We don't ask our parents for money.
So. Wow.
Sorry, thank Mom. You.
It's the truth. Okay. It comes out.
I mean, I still ask that.
Yeah, no. Sorry.
Okay, well, with
Mom,
that, I
can
mean,
I get some weed money, please?
You're saying that that kind of joint won't get you high, but okay, what about like the actual weed that's out there? I mean, is there some super potent fucking strain of weed that
much
if it were that much, it would get you super fucked up?
No, yeah, I mean, they have like moon rocks and stuff, which is dehydrated flour rehydrated moon with
rocks?
Hash oil and then rolled around in key.
So in that case, that if he were to roll a joint of that shit, wouldn't that shit get you all fucked
Kilt.
Up?
Yeah.
And isn't that like dipped in hash too?
Actually, the flour is actually dehydrated and rehydrated with hash oil, and then they dip it in key or hash crystals.
Yeah.
Chief Keef.
I've actually tried that.
That's like a trifecta of weed.
See,
that's why you fucked up with the weed. You're going ham every time.
Exactly. Probably. Yeah. Probably. Hit,
chill. Go home. Go big or go home.
Because actually one of my friends smoked out my mom, and her experience was not like mine. She's just sitting back, enjoying herself, and I'm over there like...
holding on to the table? I'm going to die, motherfucker.
Table's going to break.
Honestly, though, that's the problem with most people. They honestly think like, oh, I need the strongest stuff.
That's my friend, though.
No, you just need stuff that's tailored towards you.
Enough to get you high, but not pass high.
Yeah, because I know personally, I like to smoke hybrids because I don't like to get too jittery, but I don't like to get
like
too...
What percentage cannabis? I mean, indica and what percentage sativa?
Usually like a 70-30 split. Yeah. I used to smoke sativas a lot, but now they actually give me very high anxiety.
Right.
Like, I've actually had to.
So, 70 on the indica
freeway.
Side and the rest on sativa.
Because I don't like to get too tired.
Right, now I feel like I should smoke.
Out.
I feel like it also. Now I feel like I should smoke.
Now
I'm
gonna give it another try.
It makes sense. Like she's right. Every time I've smoked weed, it's been like fucking with my friends who smoke a lot of weed, and they always get shit like moon rocks or like fucking they're dabbing or whatever the fuck.
They're not allowing you to go.
Oh, they're doing. They're fucking lacing it with cocaine or they're dipping it and shit.
Yeah.
Primos.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
She's going to ask for the cocaine-infused weed. Do they
can
do
I just
that?
Get the,
is that a thing?
Can I get a little cocaine-infused weed minus the weed?
I do not.
Primo? Can
I
get a primo?
Primo.
No, white girl.
Let me pee-dog it, please.
So can you give us any just last piece of advice if we decide to go to your shop, or actually not your shop, but a shop tomorrow and we want to get the most strongest shit? Don't do that, right?
Don't go strong.
Yeah, no. If you don't smoke all the time, don't get the strongest.
If you just got fired, and
you're just wasting money, basically.
Yeah, because you're not going to have a good time. You're going to not want to smoke it.
Ever again.
What if you smoke less of, like, so let's say if I get the strongest shit and I smoke it in little bits and pieces.
That could help, but it also has to be tailored towards you since you said you had high anxiety, you want to have an indica. So even if you smoke a small amount of sativa, it'll still give you a bad effect.
Oh, sure.
So you definitely just want to have like the right
indica.
Stuff.
Keep that in mind.
That's a fucking weed knowledge.
So I'm like old
gin
school.
And
so
juice.
I'm back in the
smoking
old. I'm back from the old days. So yeah, the gin and juice days.
Ay.
You know. So is chronic still out there? Is that still like a thing or no? Is that just kind of like
did that get retired?
Is that like now the dirt weed now?
Yeah.
Is chronic now considered the dirt weed?
It's house shake or
the things your edibles are made
of. Back in the day, like when I was smoking, it's like it literally was like you had like $5 bag. Or you
stress.
Had chronic,
$10 back.
Yeah, like stress weed, and then you had like a like you had stress. Chronic, which was like that's when you would find it in a like that.
Yeah.
Now it's all like that, and I'm like, fuck, dude.
But $5 was like $50 now, right?
It was like a two finger. It was a two finger bag. A $5 bag was a two finger bag. But yeah,
back
now it's like
$5.
A QP, a QP used to be like $5 for
and Coke was five cents.
Coke had real Coke in it. Coke had real Coke.
And weren't the bags always full of, like, trash, fucking...
Oh, yeah, like, sticks. Your joint would, like, pop it, crackle it.
Fucking...
It was like, fucking, should I fucking smoke it or add milk to it and fucking eat, like, a cereal and shit? And all that
snap,
crackle,
pop.
Fucking bird's nest, all kinds of weird shit. Well,
them seeds, though, man, you could grow your own shit off of that, dude.
All right, so make sure you don't eat any edibles, and if you do, then call the fucking Bambulance and watch it be fucking...
Call your daughter.
For fucking hilarious for everybody.
I love
just use caution when you're fucking smoke buying your weed, man. Don't, especially if you're a noob. If you're a noob, don't
Ronnie,
go
don't do it.
Shit.
You don't
just
need
don't
that
do it.
Yeah,
don't try
don't.
To go
yeah.
So see, now he's telling me not to do it.
No, don't do it.
No. Escalate into it.
Do it if you want to.
Stick to your heroin.
Like acid. You got to go into it with the right mindset.
Look, she's fidgeting.
Now I want to do whatever he's telling me not to do.
So let's fuck
it. Don't do acid.
But just do the indica.
I won't do acid. You know what? I'll deal with this on my own. Thank you.
I'm going to smoke the most.
It's your body. It's your
choice. She needs to talk to a therapist first, all right?
Aww.
I don't have insurance.
We've already gone through this.
I'm not licensed.
Thank you for coming down and giving us some fucking knowledge on that shit, because, you know, we don't hear it enough in Snoop Dogg's fucking songs or whatever.
Yeah. He doesn't educate us the way Seth Rogen and our guest did. I'm sorry.
Right. Thank you guys for coming down, hanging out with the pigs. Dude, you are still... You ate an edible, didn't you? She's so high. Look at that.
She's so high.
Her eyes aren't even open right now. What is going on? What's so funny?
She's an asshole.
She can't even breathe. She's an asshole.
Tell you guys about the time I shit on myself at Hard Summer. I'm glad this show's over.
Okay, wait. Yeah.
Night, night, folks.
We were gonna end the show, but
okay, wait. You shit at you. Okay, you were at. You were at.
We have so much in common. You don't understand. Oh my God.
No, I shit on myself a little bit. Hey, fuck you. All right, it's my death story.
She shit on herself. There was brown shit on her
really
shorts.
I really need to go to the bathroom.
Fuck
wait,
you.
Hold
and you were sweating everywhere. And you threw up, and I had to take care of you, and I love you.
Oh, Burley is taking care of me. I fell asleep on her knee. Thanks for taking care of me.
I couldn't stop you from shitting on yourself, though. Like,
well, you could have plugged her asshole.
I asked to go to the tent a few times before I shit on myself. So no. I could have shit elsewhere.
You thought that shit up.
Okay, you're over there sweating and so much going on.
That's to go anywhere.
Okay, so what the fuck were you on that fucked you up?
Moon rocks.
So I was on acid. Oh, we could talk about that fucking trip, girl, if you're trying to go there. Yeah. Anyway, I was on acid, which I'm really usually the mother when we do acid because I'm like, I'm
not
well
this
versed.
Time.
I feel. Fuck you, Ashley. Oh, God. Anyway, it's hot as balls out there. I'm a tiny girl.
At Hard Summer?
Yeah. I didn't drink a lot of water.
How long ago was this?
There was a lot of cocaine going around. I'm a little dehydrated. It's fine. Whatever. Sorry, Mom.
It's okay.
And then I don't know what set we were at, and then suddenly I just did not feel too hot. Well, the problem was I felt too hot. And I was like, I think I'm dying. And I was like, are you guys hot? And I'm just like sweating, my shirt literally dripping. I'm like, bro, are you good? And I'm like, no, I'm not good.
I'm on fire right
I'm
now
good. Yeah, and so I head to my lap and like I just get up and I'm like, I shit on myself.
See how
oh no,
because
I threw up.
I heard acid makes you like take amazing
shit. It was the sheer shock. It was the sheer shock that she shitted herself and she hadn't realized it yet.
Yeah, because I was like barfing and then I like went into my lap and then I came up like, it's a little sticky.
That's hot.
She's like, sticky icky, bro. Just like, sticky, motherfucker.
Christmas came early with a little kid.
There's a package in the front.
I was good for the weekend, though.
There's a package in the back porch.
By the way, the Russians pay good money for fucking porn like that. Just let you know.
Extra lube.
Oh, that video would have been millions.
I thought it would be the Japs. But. Who knows?
They all do. German, like Japs, fucking Russians.
So, thank you for sharing that awesome story.
Yeah. And you like a good shit story to end the
you
show.
You have a new friend.
We made time
right,
for that.
Right?
I was going to say, you and I have a lot in common because I've done that on like 3 occasions, minus the acid. And
just because. We understand, Ronnie. Just
I just
because.
I'm so drunk. You just because, like.
Just for the
experience. Don't trust your fart. Just. Like I've learned
we need
not
end,
to do that.
We need to end this shitty conversation.
Just because you don't want to get up from the VIP section and shit, you don't want to lose your seat and shit, and all of a sudden you just shit yourself. All right,
all right, on that note, Ronnie shit herself 3 fucking times. Pigs out.
All right. This shitty fucking show.
Oh my God. Hey, yo, DJ, stop the music.
Countdown.
5, 4, 3, 2.
Initiating shutdown sequence. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Fuck you, fuck you, fuck you. You're cool. Fuck you, I'm out.
This show may cause birth defects and or cancer. Void where prohibited in the southern red states. Official sponsor of the Special Olympics. Not really. 2% financing available for nothing. See your official Toyota dealer for recall as penalty for not buying American. This show may cause massive amounts of marijuana consumption. This show has been a joint venture of cockballs and ass. Free sale tossing available. Upon request, visit robertreese.com. Sexual relations among cousins is not incest.
Thank you.
That will conclude this evening's entertainment.